Hey class, good morning. Yeah, today we'll learn how to interpret. Yeah, how to interpret the speed time graph. Okay, let's see. Yeah, this is your speed time graph. And if you can see here, the object is moving, yeah, is moving. This one is PQ, and after that QR, and then RS, yeah. So what does it mean by PQ? Okay, this one is speed, yeah. And this is time. So if you see here the PQ, there is an increase of what? Speed. Yeah, there is an increase of speed. So PQ, the speed of the object increases, yeah, from u meter per second, this one u, to V meter per second. Okay, this is understood, yeah. Okay, next, you can find the gradient, yeah, here you can find the gradient of the graph. And if the graph is like this, so the gradient is positive, yeah, is positive. And the rate of change, of course, yeah, the rate of change of speed is positive. Okay, the rate of change, that means when your gradient is positive, your rate of change is positive. And you know, rate of change of speed, you call it acceleration, yeah. So meaning to say, your acceleration is positive, yeah. That means there is an increase of, when it is positive, there is an increase of speed, yeah. And you can calculate your acceleration, nah? The change of speed divide by the change in time, or this is gradient, nah? This is gradient. So if from this graph, if I want to find the acceleration, what I do, the change of speed, yeah. So if this graph, yeah, this graph, the change of speed is V minus U. V minus U, yeah, divide by the change of time. Yeah. So this is T1 minus 0 is T1. T1. Okay. So you can find your acceleration. This is only example formula. Later on, we will do example. Okay, so next is the area under the graph. Yeah, the area under the graph here. So the area, you can see this is a trapezium, yeah, trapezium. That is the area under the graph. PQ represent distance, yeah, represent distance travel in the period of t, yeah, t1 second here. So you can find, in other words, you can find the distance, yeah, the distance in the distance traveled for graph P, PQ. Okay. Okay. Next. Next. Let's see QR. Yeah. QR. Here. QR. What does it mean by QR? You can see here. It is the V is constant. Yeah. The V, the speed does not increase. Yeah. So you say there is no change of speed. If no change of speed, that means zero gradient. If you find your gradient, you will get zero. Okay? Because from your graph, if this one, memang of course m is zero, no gradient. Yeah, it is parallel to x. So you can say the object moves at a uniform speed. Yeah, moves. This is very important. Moves at a uniform speed. But for distant time graph, if you see this one, what do you say? The object stop. So different, for distant time graph and speed time graph, it's different. For this one, when it is parallel to x-axis, it stops. But for speed time graph, it moves. So you must know the difference. Okay, next, let me clear this. Okay, next, you look at the graph, the area under the graph. Here, what do you see? It's a rectangular, and if you find the area, what do you get? That is the distance traveled for the time t1 to t2. Okay? So the area of rectangle B is the area under the graph QR, represent the distance traveled in the period of t2 minus t1 second. Yeah? Okay. So, next is RS. Okay. What do you understand by RS here? Okay, if you see from the graph, it's there is a decrease of speed, a decrease of speed. So you say the speed for RS, the speed of the object decrease, not going back. For distant time graph, if you see something like this, this area is go back. Okay, but for this one, it's the speed decrease. Okay, that is very important. Okay. And if you find the gradient, class, if you find the gradient, you will get negative. Yeah, negative value. Meaning to say that the rate of change of speed is negative, and the term is deceleration. When your speed decrease, you call it deceleration. Yeah, and there is a change of speed over time. Yeah, the formula is still the same. Yeah, so please take note, there is no change in direction. This one, no, this is only for distant time graph. That is, the motion of the object remains in the same direction. Yeah, this one, same direction, but speed decrease. Okay, next is area under the graph. So you can see here, you have a triangle. So area under the graph will be the the distance. Yeah, you can find the distance. Okay. Under the graph, represent the distance travel in the period of T1 to T3, and if you find the time, it is T3 minus T2. Yeah. Okay. So that's it, class, for how do you interpret the speed time graph. I hope you can understand. Yeah.